Do you like modeling paste? Do you like texture paste? I love it and I love, love, love using them on my projects. So here are three different products from Crafty Scrappers. Those are in the form of paste. So one is shimmer paste, the other one is granule paste, and the third one is dazzle paste. So I thought, why not to show you on how these three different product works. So these are paste. You can use them on your mixed media projects, your scrapbooking, your card making, your tags projects, or even on your decoupage projects. So, but the use and the purpose of all these three are totally different, and I felt, why not to share this small tutorial with you all, where I can share my experience, my personal experience on how I use them and on how I use them differently on my project, and just to show you a very basic differentiate between these three paste mediums. So like I said, I'll be demonstrating these three on this cardstock, and here I have this beautiful and one of my favorite stencil from Crafty Scrappers. I really love this pattern, and I thought I'll use this and I'll show you how these three products work and how these three products actually look when you work with this. So first I will start with their shimmer paste, because that is one of the products which I started with and I still love them, and recently they have come up with some amazing shimmery paste shades in this, like all in the theme and colors of New Year's and Christmas, and I thought of starting with the shimmer paste. Now when you start when you see this jar, so it has this creamy paste, and the best part is that it is not very fluidy, so you can use this with your stencils, you can even use directly with your palette knife, but the best part is I love using them with my stencils, because I work on lots of scrapbook projects, my canvases, and I love using different textures on this. So now for the shimmer paste, this is, you can see it's so creamy, it's so buttery, and it is shiny. The best part is, if I can just show you, okay, so if you see, it is not you see, you can't feel the texture at all, but you have this shiny thing on your project. So you can see how my finger is shining, and this is actually really smooth. You can see how smoothly I can rub these with my fingers. So that's the best part of it. Now I'm going to divide this into three areas with the same stencil, and I'm going to use this one at the center. Maybe I can just have the patches for now. Okay, so I'll just take some of my shimmer paste, I'll apply this on my stencil, and I'm going to make sure that I take out all the extra portion, and you can see this is so smooth that you can actually see your stencil design, and the wastage is really less. Okay, now I think I need to apply a little more. And I'm done with my one area, and you really you are going to love this one. This is how the shimmer paste is, and this looks lovely. Now I'm going to leave it as it is, and I'm going to start with the second area. I'm going to just remove my extra paste on my bottle, and now I'm going to clean my palette knife with my napkin. Now I'm going to move on to dazzle paste. Now what's the difference in dazzle paste? So if you see, these are again the creamy paste, a little thicker, and it is not shimmery, it is completely matte. So I can show you. Yeah, okay, so can you see, can you actually see the difference in this shimmer paste? Yeah, the shimmer paste and this dazzle paste. Okay, yeah. So that's the difference between the shimmer paste and the dazzle paste. And now I'll be using some of the dazzle paste with my stencil on my page. Okay, so this is again also a very creamy paste, so you really don't need to press too hard. You really don't need to be really precise, because with the very fluid paste you need to be really careful, because they tend to smudge very fast. And this is how it looks, and you can always remove the extra easily. And here my paste is done, and can you see? So this is completely shimmery, completely the glitter one, and this is completely matte. So it is still wet, but it's matte. Even if it dries out, it is going to be complete matte, and that's the best part of the dazzle paste. I'm going to remove the extra on my jar. Now it's time to move on to your granule paste. Okay, now for the granule paste, oops, you can see how bad I had kept my bottle. Okay, so now for the granule paste, you can see some white polka dots in this. Yeah, so these are the granules, and if I apply them on my finger, can you see some texture? Can you see some textures here? Okay, so this is how. So these are the three difference. This is the shimmer paste, this is the dazzle paste, and this one is the granule paste. So this is just perfect for all your texture work. If you just want to play rough hand and do some texture work, or even if you want to do this with the stencil. So here I'm going to keep the third portion of my stencil. I'm going to use a very small portion here, and okay, can you see the texture? Somewhere it's flat, somewhere it's texture, and this is just perfect. I personally feel the best use of granule paste is when you just take it with your brush or your palette knife and you just spread it, and you can see the texture all around. So this is one of the very good product what Crafty Scrapper has come up, because being a mixed media artist, I really need to keep so many stuff handy when I'm doing any of the mixed media projects, and it becomes difficult for me, like when my paste is wet, I need to add some granules to it. So this is just perfect. I'll show you a close up. Okay, can you see the texture and how amazing it looks? And the best part is, this is so creamy and so wet that you can actually play around with your tools. Like if I want to have some say design here, or I just want to play around with my palette knife or something, and I have some really nice texture over here. So you can just add these granule paste and play around with your tools, and you have some amazing designs. So I hope you all know by now that what's the difference in shimmer paste, the dazzle paste, and the granule paste. Maybe I'll just write it down here so that it's easy for all of you. And the very important thing that dazzle paste, the shimmer paste, they come in different colors. They have some amazing collection of colors of these. Like I have 2-3 of my baskets full of all the dazzle paste and the shimmer paste, and I love them. I use them for my mixed media projects a lot. So this one is granule paste, dazzle, and shimmer paste. So this was my small video on how to use this shimmer paste. Now How much time does it take to dry out? These three pastes, especially the granule paste, takes a little more time to dry out. Then the second one, a shimmer paste, and dazzle paste is something which dries out really, really, really fast. And if you work, if you ask me for the colors, these two comes with amazing shades. Like, I can even show you some of the really, really nice shades which I have. So, like, this is one of the sea glass shade I have. Then so like I said, shimmer paste and dazzle paste, they come in different shades. With the granule paste, it's come right now, they just have the white shade, and you can, once it dries out, you can really add colors to it. Maybe I can just show you a small sample here. Okay, so now I have the shimmer spray, and maybe I can add some nice shade to this granule paste. As you can see how it looks, and here is a pinch of yellow. And can you see, it absorbs colors so nicely, and once it dries out, it is going to have some really nice shade. And the best part, the reason why I love Crafty's copper products is because you can actually blend them really well. You can mix and match the products because they have a huge, huge, huge collection of shimmer paints, shimmer sprays, and shimmer paste, dazzle paste, granule paste. And with one company, with one brand, you have all the supplies, which is just perfect for your mixed media projects. So I hope you all like this project, like this tutorial. And if you have any queries, please do comment below. I'm sharing all the links of these supplies in the description box. Do check that. And if you want me to make some more videos on how to use different products, please do mention that in the comment section and leave some love. Thank you so much for watching. Bye bye.